Hello everybody, thanks for joining this webinar. Let's talk 1 hour together regarding our latest software that we have developed in the last few years. This new platform is specifically designed for the testing of the protection relays. In this picture we can see the basic components of the platform. So since we are talking about protection relays, there is a section dedicated to the management of the settings of the relay. We all know that complex relays like distance protection or differential protections has inside a lot of parameters. So it's extremely useful to have software able to give the possibility to the user to handle this quantity of parameters in the most convenient and easy way. The testing of the relays needs a device, a relay test set. Our test set is called DRTS, and for this reason we need a software there to configure all the hardware, all the options inside the test set. For example, it's possible to enable or disable digital inputs or digital outputs, or for example, program the connections in parallel of the current output, but also possible to set many other parameters. Every protections has specific functions, and for every function there is a specific test modules. All these test modules can be collected together to create a test plan. This is specifically designed for multifunction relays. So we can prepare a sequence of tests, and in the end all the results are collected into a unique report. The report is managed by a component that gives the possibility to customize the report, giving the appearance that is more convenient for the user. For example, it's possible to add or remove values, the values that are actually generated by the voltage and current output, or add the logo of your company or add the pictures. So it's possible to manage as you wish in order to create the best appearance for your test results. The Relay Setting Manager gives the possibility to import directly the file, the settings file that you can extract, export from different relay models. Can be an ABB, a Siemens, Schneider, General Electric. These different models export in different format, for example, RIO files, XRIO files, XML, TXT or CSV. So once you export this file, you can immediately import into Relay Setting Manager. But in case you don't have a file to be imported, we can provide a dedicated template per each different relay that give the possibility to insert manually all the parameters necessary for the testing that you are going to do. As we said before, the DRTS configurator is here to enable or disable the part of the hardware necessary for the test that you are going to do. These are, for example, the current output, these are the voltage output, these are the digital input, these are the digital output. So every part is fully configurable according to your needs. And the software to be used for this setting is called the DRTS configurator. The test plan editor is here to call one by one all the test modules that you need, put in a sequence, all the results will be collected into the same test report. Once you get the report, you can export into many formats, can be, for example, a PDF file or a Microsoft Office format. TDMS Pro is provided with two licenses. One is called Standard License, and the second one is called Advanced License. You can see the list of the test modules that are part of the standard and the list of the advanced. So the difference between the two, you can see, is that in case of the advanced, that represents the full software platform, is also possible to have the test plan editor, the distance protection, all the differential protection, and the management of the protocol 61850. So since this is a license, it is based on the DRTS serial number. So inside the license is written what is the serial number of the device that you are going to be connected. And this this license can be installed into multiple computers. So with the same license, you can use many laptops. What is important is that the serial number of the DRTS you're going to connect corresponds to the one inside the license. This slide is here to avoid misunderstanding. We have several models of protection related set, but not all of them are supported by the new TDMS Pro. So all the models, DRTS 33, 34, 64, and 66 can be used with DRTS, with TDMS Pro. But the more old devices like DRTS 3, 3 Plus, and 6, they are not possible to be used with TDMS Pro. So this is here to be clear. Okay, this is a very short introduction. So now we go directly to see how is done the software. Okay, just let me understand how to. Okay, so this is the home page of the software. There are many icons. Each one represents a test module and a section. If with the mouse pointer I select the protected module, all the softwares that belongs to this category are highlighted. So we can recognize here the Relay Setting Manager, the DRTS Configurator, the Test Plan Editor, and all the others. But let's start with our first test. So imagine that we are going to test a distance protection. So I click on this icon. A second, because I have two screens. So okay, so once the software is executed, you see this window. So this part is dedicated to the distance protection characteristic. In this case is empty because at the moment I did not select yet what is the characteristic that I'm going to test. So the first step will be the selection of the characteristic. So I'm going to call the Relay Setting Manager software. So I'm clicking on this icon, and I see here that the characteristic is not present because this corresponds to the condition that I have in this moment. So in my example, I'm going to test a distance protection specific model, a Siemens 7SA. So I'm going to click on New, and I select a specific model. Then I choose Siemens, the series C-Protect 4, and the model 7SA61X. Then I have two possibilities. If I have the XRIO file in this case, because it's a Siemens protection, I can import directly the file and see that the specific template that corresponds to this model is uploaded with all the parameters already present according to the values present in the XRIO. So I click on import file. This is the XRIO. Open. And this is the characteristic. So you can see in very few clicks, all the parameters are here for you. Okay, so we can see that there are five zones. We can enable, disable. So we can also do modifications after the XRIO file is imported. So you can see. So once the setting file is imported, we press exit, and the characteristic is uploaded. Once the characteristic is uploaded, I can choose what is the test that I'm going to do. So this represents the section where I decide what is the fault that I'm going to simulate. So you see that if there is a different characteristic for face-to-face faults, also the graph here change accordingly. Then this sequence is here to help me to decide what are the values that I'm going to generate. So the most convenient is starting from a pre-fault condition. So with a pre-fault condition, the relay for sure is not tripping. Then I select, I start to generate the fault for a specific maximum time. This is 1 second, but I can modify, it's not a problem. And after the trip is recognized, automatically the pre-fault condition is generated. So the relay will not trip anymore. This is convenient when I do a sequence of tests. Imagine that I have to do 5 tests in a row, and every time the relay is tripping, in order to measure another tripping time, I need to see that the trip contact is reset to the no trip condition. In this section here, I can see what are the tests that are available here. The most fast and easy possible test is called click and test. As the name suggests, I can click directly on the characteristic here, click, and if in the in case I am connected to the test set, this test is immediately generated and I can see the result in a very short time. Now I'm not connected, so you can see that if I click in several parts of the characteristic, the tests are added here in this table. So in this column, I see the magnitude of the impedance and also the angle. So if you pay attention to this value, if I click in a region where the angle is close to zero, the value here is close to zero, and here you can see is more or less 8 ohms. Since we know the characteristic, we know also the trip time for every zone. And in this column, you can see that if I click in the first zone here, the trip time is, the nominal trip time is zero, because this is the typical value for the zone one. For higher zone, the trip time also increases. Okay, so this is one possibility. So in order to save time, I prepared some videos because we will do during this session a good number of tests in order to avoid to program different relays and connect and disconnect different relays. Is much more convenient to see the real test inside videos. So the first video that we are going to see together is this one, the click and test. Okay, so first step is to connect the DRTS. So you can see clicking zone one. In this table, I can see that the measure time is present inside this column, and we can see immediately that the measure time is the same, more or less the same, of the nominal one. So the result is considered to be correct, with a clear indication here in the column pass/fail. All the tests are correct. Now, we see an example of a test that is not correct, and the indication is red. Why is not correct? Because the trip time is not inside the tolerances. So, there is the nominal time, but also there is a tolerance on this time. So there is a minimum time and also a maximum time. And we see from here that the measure time is a little bit higher than the maximum. That's why the test is failed. Okay. I see that someone is asking question into the section dedicated to the questions. In this webinar, I am alone, so please be patient a little bit. I will answer to your question in the end of the session. But please feel free to ask all the questions you want. Okay, so this is the very first example that we can discuss together. Okay. Now I needed to see how to remove this window. Okay. Very good. Okay, but click and test is something that you can use to see, for example, if the trip contact of the relay is well programmed, if it is well connected, if everything is fine. But this is a simple test. We can do something better. For example, the verification of the characteristic, the automatic one. So let me remove this test. Okay, and we see that there is the possibility to do an automatic characteristic verification. So this red cross is here to indicate where we are testing the border of this zone. These cross are placed according to the settings. So for example, if I start from 0 degrees, you see that the red cross start from the zero. I can put 350. And you see, if I increase also the step of this angle, the number of tests is reduced, because starting from zero, the first. Sorry, the first test is starting at 50 degrees, then 100, and so on. I can also decide to verify not all the zones, but maybe only the first two. So I can remove the zone 3 and zone 4, and then the test will be done only for zone 1 and zone 2. Then I add the test, and I see that 8 tests are into the list. Must be specified that the verification of the border will be in this way. So there will be executed some tests around this point, so a little bit over and a little bit below the border, following a line that is perpendicular to the border. So in case like this, the test will be executed in a vertical direction. In a case like this, they will be in a horizontal direction. Okay. Also for this test, I prepared a video that now I'm going to execute. Okay. Oops, no, it's not the video, it's another one, sorry, it's this one. Okay. So here, this video, repeating the same operations that we discussed before. So I'm reducing the number of tests because otherwise this test will last for too long time and is not adding information, relevant information. So the concept is valid for few tests and all, and is the same for many tests. Okay. There is also the possibility to see the tolerances around the zones. We edit the test and pressing start, they are executed. I don't know if you can see, but there is a square here around that is indicating where the test is in execution. This is more or less a 1 minute long test. So I hope you can see this small cross around. Okay, so all the tests are passed. So we have to see that before the test is executed, the value in these columns represent the exact value that comes from the nominal characteristic, but if the result is will be different, then also the number here will be different. Okay, you can see. It's a very easy test. Okay, just a few more seconds and the test will be finished. Okay. Another possibility to select the part of the characteristic to be tested is called border test. So, okay, just to be more clear, let me remove the test here. So if I select the verify border, I can select only few pieces. This part is convenient, for example, for this part of the characteristic where is more difficult maybe to select the proper section that you want to test. So if I'm interested in, for example, just this and this, I just click on the piece of the characteristic, and I also can decide how many tests I want to do per each segment. So these are 20 or 2, so you are free to decide. Another possibility is this, so you can select a full characteristic, and then all the tests are inside automatically. So I prepared another video, very short video, that show how to create and execute a test like this. Okay, so I'm interested in the selection of this part. You can see that if I move the mouse on the section, it is also highlighted, then start. And the execution of this test is made again in the same manner of the verify characteristic. So the test will be always performed along a direction that is perpendicular to the border. So I'm testing the execution is here. Okay. So we see that two results are not okay. And the indication here, I stop a little bit the video. So this square is here to indicate that the border is not in this position, because he tried to look for this border. The algorithm was not able to find it. And for this reason, there is this fail indication. So the next test that I can do is to go back to the click and test, do a few clicks here around, and I can verify where the real border is placed. So instead to be an out of zone, so this means that the trip time is must be timeout, the result was that it was tripping in 0.5 seconds. And here is not tripped. So the real border is somewhere here around. So I'm free to continue to click somewhere in order to identify where is the border. Okay, I can move on a little bit. Okay. Okay, I'm moving. Okay, so the color also represent the pass fail. So the red dot is a fail test, the green is a pass. So we see, we can imagine that the border is passing through a different direction. Okay, I pause once again the video. So the result table gives the possibility to make groups. So what I am going to do here is to group the results that are passed and the results that are failed. So in this list, they are mixed, but the group give me the possibility to see how many tests has been executed with the fail results and how many are passed. And there is also a number that is telling me how many, 8 and 8 in this case. The groups can be done with any parameter. I choose in this example the pass-fail because it's the say most common group that we can imagine, but we can also group by type of fault, type of test, and whatever we want. Okay. So this was a brief introduction on how to test disaster protection with the new software. So I'm passing now to another test module. Now we are going to discuss about the overcurrent, and what we will see is that the software will look very, very similar to this. This is an advantage because if you know how to use one test module, you 95% prepared to test by using any other module. So long story short, let's close this and open the phase overcurrent test module. Okay, so this is a default setting that I can change, and now we know how. We go to setup and we change the parameters by selecting the relay setting manager. Okay, in this example we are going to input manually the parameters. So with the distance protection we understood how to import files with specific templates. In this case we see how to make a characteristic manually. Okay, let's see that in this part we are going to modify from a definite time characteristic. I select a time dependent characteristic. I can modify all the parameters available here. I can also add a second piece of curve. Let's see, so D5, and also add another one, modify the trip time. You see, it's very easy, and all the setting that you change, you have an immediate view on what you are going to prepare. This is the directional sector. We see that it is present at all angles because all the curves are not directional. If I change this and go to, for example, to choose the forward, I see that between plus 90 and minus 90, the threshold is present, otherwise is not present, and I can modify like this. I can also modify here. So you are free to do whatever you wish in a very convenient way. I can do it for all the characteristics. Okay, once the characteristic is ready, can press exit and the characteristic is here. Now, since is not all the thresholds are not present at every angle, this plot will represent what are the what are the overcurrent characteristics at a specific angle represented by this red line. So if I change the direction of the red line, I can also see that the overcurrent characteristic will change accordingly. If I choose an angle where no characteristics are present, then the graph here will be empty. So I can continue and I see. Okay. So you see the screen is very similar to the distance protection. There is the central part dedicated to the trip characteristic. There is the left part dedicated to the result. So this is a result table. And this is sorry, this was the right. This is the left panel where I can decide what is the test that I'm going to do on this specific characteristic. We see that there is again the click and test because it's a very convenient way where you can click on the characteristic and the test is immediately added and also executed to have an immediate understanding if everything's fine with connections and settings between the relay and the test set. There is also the possibility to add values in a row like this automatically. Say 15, step 2. Okay, you can see the angle. Okay, so and pressing add, they are added. Okay, also for this simple test, I prepared a video in which we can see more features about the possibilities given by the test modules. I can anticipate that we will see something like the manipulation of this part. We can hide or show in this example the directional sector. We can also merge the graphs because if you are not interested in some part or if you are using a laptop with a low resolution screen, maybe it's convenient to hide some parts in order to highlight other parts that are more interesting for you. Okay. Very well. Okay. In our example here, the relay is not a directional relay, so is not convenient to keep in front the directional sector. So we see with the click and test that is enough to click on the characteristic, the test is added and immediately executed. So the nominal time we see is more or less 8 seconds, so we have to wait more or less 8 seconds, okay. As we said before, the color of the point is green because the test is passed. In case the test is failed, will be red, as in this case. This was an intentional mistake. I removed the trip contact intentionally in order to see a timeout here and give me the possibility to show you and discuss what happened in a case like this. So I connect back the trip contact, I repeat the test, and after 4 seconds, yes, I have the result. Can continue, so another click, another test, another result. Okay. This is what I was saying before. It's possible to make a floating every panel into the test module. In this example, I decided to make floating the result table and reduce the dimension of the table and put in a corner of the screen. Yes, it's also possible to see what are the waveforms that are generated, and here we see what is the behavior of the contacts connected to the DRTS. In this case, there are only two contacts connected. The contact called C1 is the trip contact, and the contact 2 is called the pickup contact. So we see that the pickup change his status when the fault starts, so this is the current generation, and the trip comes only in the end, so when the trip time is reached. Okay, so I put in pause once again. I go back a little bit so you can see. So before before the execution and during the execution, these digital lines are empty because we have not yet results to be plotted. But once the result is acquired, then they appear on the graph. Okay, we can zoom. There is the possibility to auto-scale. Move the markers. Okay, so I can place the marker, the two marker, in the position that I want. I can see here on top that the difference in time between the two markers is 200 milliseconds, but in the result table, we see that the nominal is a little bit more, sorry, the measure time is a little bit more because the trip time starts to be counted when the fault is started. Yes, but if I move the marker exactly when the current starts to be generated, okay, the time here now, okay, we were not so precise in the placement, but just to give the idea that now the time indicated here is 230 milliseconds, that is more or less the same measure time here in the table. Okay. Okay, so we can discuss a lot about this. There are several several settings here, but it's not so useful in this webinar to discuss about each and every detail, otherwise it will take too long time, but for me it's important that you understand what are the main features, and first of all, what are the common features between all the test modules. We see also that there is the test report. It is here. So you can see that can be, let's say, extended where is present the test one, test two, test three, with the default values and also the generated value. But this can occupy a lot of pages. If I'm not interested to see, for example, the generated values, I can go to Report, Print Settings. I can, for example, remove everything. So instead to have several pages, I see everything in a single page. So the concept is, if you go to Print Settings, you are free to add and remove parts into the test report. Let me do another example. I want to add what are the settings of the relay. I do apply, and the table that represent the settings of the relay is now present into test report. If I want to export to PDF, I click here, I put it like test, okay, let me go on my desktop in order to let you see that it is correctly exported. Okay. Very good. So the next test is to use the manual control. The manual control is a software that gives you the possibility to manually input all the current value, all the voltage value, angles, frequency, enable and disable digital input as you wish in order to create your own test. I decided to prepare an example based on the testing of the overcurrent characteristic. In particular, to repeat this test, the one that we saw in the video before, but using manual control. So for the moment, I click, I close this, I open manual control. So we first have a look inside, a brief look inside, in order to understand how it is made. Okay, so this part on the left is dedicated to the voltage and current value. I can decide to put, for example, to train to 30 volts, and the phasors appear accordingly. Also, I can put 20 amp, change the angle. Okay, so very easy. Here in this section, I can enable and disable the binary inputs. And in this field, now there is a zero, will be indicated the trip time of this particular binary input in the end of the test. I can input the values directly in voltage and current, but there is also the possibility to set values in different representations. For example, setting in line-to-line representation. Let me put a different value just to see. Also add a zero sequence component for the voltage, change the angle. Okay, so this is a very basic possibility. There is also the possibility to do symmetrical components, powers, and also impedances. But in order to go to impedance, we come here. So, but from where this characteristic come from? Again, from the Relay Setting Manager. So if I go to Setup Relay Settings, the Relay Setting Manager is open, and I see from where the characteristic is coming from. And I can also see that is coming from the Siemens 7SA 611 in my case, protection. Okay, how to create a test list is possible here. So I can press this button add and the test is added. I can also decide to make a multiple input with a single click. This icon is here to enable this panel where I can set the step. So it's more easy to see rather than explain by words. So let me put easy numbers here. So if I start from 10 volts and I add a delta of, let's say, 2 volts on all the three channels, and I decide to add, I don't know, 6 tests, once I press add, automatically the values are input. Okay, so let me execute the video because it's quite complete. So it will be much more easy for you to follow the logic about the use of this software by looking to this video. Remember that what we are going to do is to find the trip characteristic of an overcurrent protection. So what is our idea is to add multiple tests starting from 2 amps with steps of 400 milliamp on current output 1. This table can be composed by several, several columns. But not all of them are always necessary for you. So there is a possibility to choose what are the columns that you want to make visible, because too many columns are not convenient. So there is a section dedicated to the parameters. There is also a description of every parameter. In this case, C1 is the measure time of the input C1. With this arrow, it's possible to remove and add the columns. And very important, it's possible to save some preset combinations of columns. Otherwise, every time you have to prepare the column layout. So it's convenient to have the possibility to save. Now we are going to test to add other test because the first part is dedicated to the time dependent characteristic, and the second part of the test that we added is dedicated to the definite time part of the characteristic. So having pressing start, so we start from the first and the trip time was 9 seconds. This is 7, 6. So we see that we are collecting results from a time dependent overcurrent characteristic. So it will take a few seconds. Okay, in the meantime, I'm reading your questions. Okay, so I will answer in the end. Okay, so the tests are completed. So what we are going to do now is to try to plot the values So I have the possibility to plot a Cartesian graph on which we can decide what is the X, what is the Y parameter. So since this is a overcurrent on the horizontal axis, there is the current, on the vertical there is the trip time. That's why the dimension of the horizontal is ampere and the dimension of the vertical is seconds. And there is also the possibility to choose the type of the scale. It can be a logarithmic or a standard one. Let's continue adding the parameters. I can also decide the color, and this is the results. Zoom. And thanks to the possibility to split the graph in two, the panel in two, I can see in the same time the values in the result table and the result represented into the graph. Okay. Stop. Okay, so just one more example will be the differential transformer protection. We will not stay a long time, but again is to highlight the concept that every software module will look very similar to each other. And also to give you an idea that there are dedicated templates also for the differential protections. Okay, so once again, on the right there is the result table, in the middle the trip characteristic, on the left you decide the type of test that you are going to So this characteristic comes from the Relay Setting Manager. Once again, go to Setup, I click on Relay Settings, and I see here the characteristic. But let's do from the beginning a new one, so it will be more clear how to use the Relay Setting Manager. So let me reduce it, see it's more clear. So new. I'm going to decide to use a specific model, General Electric Multilin T60. Okay, this now is another way to use the Relay Setting Manager, because I don't want to import a file, I want to continue without importing a file, but using a specific template that belongs to a specific model. So I click on continue without importing and start a guided procedure. So according to the model that I selected, there is a list here that represents what are the protected functions that can be present inside that specific model. So the General Electric T60 is a complete relay where you can find inside a distance protection, a phase over current, earth over current, differential protection for two winding or three winding transformers. I can also enable more than one protected function in the same time, because they can be active more than one in the same time. But in our example, we are interested to understand how to handle the parameters of a transformer differential. Okay, these are the nominal values for the primary and the secondary. Let's say that is 400 kilovolt, 160. These are just numbers, can be any number, of course. Okay. In the end, we see here a dedicated template for this specific model. So you see, you can decide what is the vector group, star delta, delta star, if it's grounded or not, and what is the trip characteristic. So I can modify here. Not all values are possible. Okay. There is also the possibility to set the harmonic blocks. For this relay are possible only the second and the fifth harmonic block. Okay, so once it's ready, the characteristic is here for you. We can make zoom. And from this part, we can decide the test, the fault. So it can be a fault that simulates a fault on the high voltage side or the low voltage side. So there is a reason why this curve change if I also change the transformer side. Actually, this explanation will take more than a few minutes, so I'm not going to be detailed on this explanation, just a few words. When we generate a fault that is not a symmetrical fault, for example, a fault that involves only one phase, in particular condition, for example, when there is a star or a delta, sorry, when there is a delta side connected, if there is a fault on the start side, there will be only one current in the star side, but not only one current in the delta side. This means that the elements for phase A, B, and C are stimulated differently. So in order to handle these differences, in the end, is convenient to redesign with different shape the characteristic in order to be always in the condition to click on the region that is above this line, and the relay always trips, and when we do testing below the line, the relay is always in timeout. I know this is not a complete explanation, but it's not the purpose of this webinar to discuss about the theory of the transformer differential protection. I prepared a video also for this. Let me open it. Okay. Again, there is a possibility to perform the click and test. Clicking the region above the line, the relay must trip. Clicking below the line, the relay must remain in a no trip condition. And we see in the table that this behavior is confirmed. So in the example, I did different tests with different type of fault just to confirm that the relay is tripping correctly in all different conditions. In case of harmonic block, there is the same possibility to perform a click and test. So in this, the horizontal X now represent the percentage of harmonics. In this case, the threshold is placed at 20% of the second harmonic. So same as the differential characteristic, also in this case, in the region above the line, the relay mass strip, in the region below the line, the relay must remain in the no trip condition. Why? Because if the harmonic is more than the program threshold, the relay must avoid to issue the trip. So this way to handle the test of harmonics is very easy and very convenient because the percentage that belongs to the place where you click is represented here. It is generated and you can see if it trips or not. You can see the third column in the test results table that now I expect. Okay. In this case was tripping, but the result is pass because there are tolerances. So inside the tolerances that we can see now, the relay is allowed to trip or not trip, but outside the tolerances band, for example in this case, if it trips is not a good result, but since the relay did not trip, then the result is okay. Okay, so having discussed about the single test modules, it's now time to discuss about the test plan editor. So the test plan editor is a software that gives the possibility to, as I said before, put in sequence several test modules in order to have a single result, a single report with all the results together. I see in the meantime that the questions are, the number of questions are increasing, so be patient. This is the last part of software that I'm going to show you. Later on, I will answer to your questions. Okay, so the test plan starts empty, of course. So I have to create a new one. Since I'm going to test a multifunction relay, this is the main reason to have a test plan, I need to prepare the settings of this relay. So I double click on this line that represents the relay setting manager, double click. Okay, this is a default characteristic that I'm going to modify. For example, this is an overcurrent, but I also want to add a distance protection, for example. So I do new. In this case, let's do Alstom. Say continue without import, just to see once again that I can select more than one protection at the same time. These are nominal values, so important. Okay, so we have the distance protection and also the overcurrent protection that I can modify, add. Okay, maybe this must be one. Okay. This is not so correct. I put one. Ah, sorry, this must be. Okay, this is more okay. Okay, press exit. I can also decide to change some configuration into the relay settings, sorry, in the DRTS configuration. I can decide to click in this region and enable or disable some binary inputs. by easily clicking on this title of this column, I can program them to be dry or wet contact. Okay, press exit and the RTS configurator is ready. Now I can add the test modules in sequence. Okay, so since in this example there are available the overcurrent and the distance protection, I can add a test of overcurrent. After that, I can add a distance. Okay, these names are sort of default name that I can change if I need. So if I click here, I can expand the property panel and I can change. I can call it main protection and add some description like 21 and 51 enabled. You see immediately here that this description is present. The icon here also is here to help you to understand what is the module that you are going to use. So this part, for example, in distance, is the same icon that you can find in the home page that represent in symbols what is the a possible trip characteristic, a possible shape of a trip characteristic. But anyway, I can modify this. I can give a name like 64. Then this can be routine test one. Okay, like 51 protection. These are examples you understand. In test 2, 21 protection. I can also add messages. For example, if I want to test the 50 protection, the overcurrent protection, and in the same time, in order to be sure that the two protective functions are not overlapping, I can also decide to disable the distance protection while I'm testing the overcurrent. So I can add messages like this. I can add a message like disable the distance protection. And also move, because I want that this message comes immediately, immediately before I execute the overcurrent protection. So I go to operations and I move up. Then I can add another message that can be enable. Okay, and move it up. Now I'm going to add the test. So clicking on this line, the overcurrent characteristic is uploaded into the test software. This is the same software that we saw before. So I can add few tests, press exit. And we see here that the tests are already added. They are not executed, so this indication is gray. Is the indication that the test is not executed. Now, I'm going to add the distance protection. So double click. I can add test, press exit. And you see that there are two lines here in the summary that are correlated to the distance test that I added. If I go below, I see that. There is also the distance and the test here in the sequence. So the test plan can be complex as you want. We will not waste too many minutes to trying to create another example more complex. The concept is that you can add all the modules in a sequence as you want. For this, I prepared the last video, this one, that show how to the test plan behaves once the test plan is prepared. So automatically, the test module is uploaded, sorry, is executed, and one by one, all the tests inside are executed, and the results are written into the final report. So this is the operator message. Okay, this is a very easy example. Okay, so now we see how the final report look like. So this is a cover, this is a summary, this is the relay settings in a table. Okay, so you see there are all the values, there is the graph that represent the test into the trip characteristic, and there is this green indication that is here to say that all the tests are passed. Okay, this report is quite long because there are several data to be represented. Now we are going to remove some of them in order to see that the number of pages is reduced. Yes. Okay, so you see that the tables are more short. So. Okay, so every time you do this kind of a modification, then in real time the test report is modified. You can zoom in and zoom out in the same way that you do with the web pages, because this works more or less as a web page. So with your mouse, if you keep pressed the control button and you move the mouse wheel, then you can perform the zoom on this page. Okay, one interesting possibility here is that if you're not interested to let me say in a better way, if you have a complex test plan and for some reason you don't want to print a report that include every results, it's possible to exclude some result from the report by simply clicking to this parameter that is including to the report or not. So the phase over current is excluded. Maybe better to that I go back. The phase over current is excluded. So here is present. Now we remove from the report. And automatically you can see that also from the summary, that is not present anymore. If we scroll the page down, we see that the first test that we get is the distance. The overcurrent is not present. Then you can include in the report and the overcurrent is back. There is also the possibility, if you see here in the left bottom corner, it's possible not only to exclude from the report, but it's also possible to avoid the execution. Why? If you prepared in the past a complex test plan, and for some reason you cannot execute all the tests, instead of remove the test from the test plan, you can just decide to do not execute that test. Okay, so this is the test plan editor. That is the last module that I wanted to discuss together with you. Okay, so we are well in time. So the sessions was calibrated to be 1.5 hour long. And now it's time to read some of your questions and try to give an answer. Okay, so the first questions are regarding the license. Let me see. Is the software free or free of charge and will be delivered together with the instrument? Okay, this is important that we clarify. The full software will always be provided with the instrument. So we are not adding cost comparing to the past. So the price of the instrument will remain the same, and as we always did in the past, the test set always come with the full software. The standard license that give the possibility to use less modules, for example, the standard that does not include the test plan editor, is there to for all the people that they don't need, and this will give a possibility to have a price reduction. So this is important to be understood. So we introduce the concept of license not to add costs, but to reduce the cost. So just to repeat once again, we are not going to modify to add extra prices if you compare the price now with the past. The benefit is that if you are not interested in some of the test modules, then you get a price reduction. I hope this explanation was clear enough to clarify the reason why we introduced these two license levels. Then there is another question like, do you need to renew and pay annually? No. There is no charge for upgrades. So once you have your license, you get access to all the upgrades that we will release. What about the number of users? The license is linked to the serial number of the DRTS. So if you have one license, you can import in many laptops. So the number of users is no limit, but all of these users can be connected only to the DRTS with a serial number that is written inside the license. Okay. Let me see other questions. How many points to be tested in case of 50-51? A lot. I mean, there is no specific limit. So you can add all the tests that you want. Then, Is it possible to highlight the fail parameter in the table? Okay, this can be a good idea. At the moment, there is no, for example, there is no a change color of the parameter that is used to decide if the test is pass or fail. Okay, this is something that we can think about in order to make our result table more clear. But just to answer, at the moment, the parameter that we use to decide what is pass and what is fail is the one that is inside the tolerances table. So you have to click on the tolerances icon inside every software, then it tells you what are the parameter that are used to decide the pass and fail. Then there are questions from our distributors, okay, I ask to those distributors that are asking questions here, please send me an email and I will answer to these specific questions, because these are questions that are interesting only for our distributors. How I can get the video after the session? You will receive an email in the end of the sessions with links of the recorded section. And in a few days, there will be also available on Altanova website. I am using the, let's say, the previous TDMS software. How can I upgrade it? Okay, the previous platform and this platform can be installed together. So you don't need to remove from your computer the previous TDMS. So they can stay together. So this is not an upgrade of the old. This is a brand new platform. You see now the number of questions are increasing a lot. You see. Okay. Then please share the video. Yes, will be shared in the end. You will receive an email. Then there is a question like, is possible to connect the RTS over Ethernet? Yes. Yes. Same like before. So the possible communication is through USB or Ethernet. When the TDMS Pro software will be available? Very soon. So we waited first to have this official launch through this webinar. So in a few days will be available. But in order to get it, you have to be in touch with us, because we have also to understand how to provide the license key. So the license key is not something that you can get from the website. All manufacturers really include to this TDMS Pro complete. Okay, as it is normal, the first release will not include a complete list redesigned in the new, but there is a very good plan, development plan to produce new templates. But important to say that the old template, now I have to say old, in the TDMS, in the previous TDMS platform, can be used in order to export a file that can be imported into the TDMS Pro. So in the meantime, all the templates that are more or less 100 present into the previous platform can be used to export a file to be imported into TDMS Pro. So there is one, let's say, one more passage, but this opened the possibility to reuse the previous platform There are a lot of questions about prices. I hope that I already answered. What about power swing testing? Okay, so same like templates. The first release will not come with all the functionalities. Power swing is one that will come in further releases. So it's a module that is present into the previous platform, so you can still use it. And in the near future will be developed something similar and even better module into the TDMS Pro. Let me see. So other questions regarding power swing, so I just repeat, is present in the previous platform, available for everyone. In future, very in near future releases, the module dedicated to the power swing will be also developed for the TMS Pro. I see here a lot of detailed questions that the answers will take me 15 minutes to be explained. So for all of you that are interested for very specific details, please send me an email and I will be glad to give you a proper answer in a written form that is much more convenient than speak here for a long time. Please share your email address. Okay, yes, you're right. My email address is this. I plot. One second, please. Hope you can see. Sorry, I forgot to add a slide with my contacts in the end of the presentation. Sorry for this. Okay. End-to-end test include in this software. Yes. Is a part that I intentionally skip because it's a very detailed, but I can also answer. So end-to-end test means line differential testing. So in order to be able to do this test is fundamental to have the GPS. The possibility to be synchronized to the GPS. So let me open this just for example, but this is common to all the softwares. Just a second, okay, here. If I come here and I see test start settings, what is this? I mean, if you don't have the GPS active, then the only possibility is to start with no other condition. What does it mean? When you press start, it starts immediately. But if you have the GPS, then you can set a specific time in order to inject default quantity. In this case, is not available because into the DRTS configuration, the internal GPS is not activated. So in very few clicks, I can show you how to enable this GPS. So you can see here, this is the list of optionals available into the DRTS. One of these is internal GPS. I click, so it changed the color style. This means that it is activated. Then I press exit. And if I go back to the test start settings, I see that it's possible now to select a specific time here. Now, I'm not connected to a DRTS because I don't have here on the table, but if you are connected to the DRTS and the DRTS is connected to the GPS antenna, then the field that corresponds to the current hour will be synchronized with the GPS time. And here you can manually input at what specific time the test will start. So this feature is available in all the software modules, can be manual, can be overcurrent, can be distance, can be differential. So the end-to-end test is a normal test, but synchronized with GPS. So the answer is yes, it's possible. In order to see a real test like this, it's complex. So that's why I had no possibility to prepare a video for this, but for sure, we have a plan for more advanced webinar for specific topics dedicated for specific functions, for example, distance protection, transformer differential, line differential, and other interesting topics. In such webinar, then we will manage to arrange useful and interesting tests, such as the end-to-end test. Then there are other questions regarding the test, the test protection template. I repeat once again, the first release will not include hundreds of models, but there is a very good plan of the development. But in the meantime, we are still we still give the possibility to use the previous platform, where there are more or less 100 models. In each one of them, it will be possible to export a file to be imported into the TDMS Pro, and in this way, those hundreds of template can be reused into the new platform. Okay, so I did not answer to all the questions because I repeat once again, these questions are too specific, you know, to be answered here just speaking. So please send me an email. The email is this one. I will be glad to provide you an answer. Okay, so thanks all of you for your time to have joined this webinar, to spend some time together. I hope you enjoyed our software. We try to make the software in such a way to make the life of the commissioning engineer as easy as possible. I hope you can appreciate this. Okay, so thank you all. And bye, and see you at the next section. Bye bye. Grazie.